Hi guys, welcome back to this video. I've recently come across this clever design of a print-in-place box with a hinged lid, link in the description. The creator only shared the STL files, so if you want to change the design for your purposes, you might want to redesign it using the techniques I'll be showing in this video. So without further ado, let's have a look at how we can use Autodesk Fusion Sketcher to develop such a seemingly complex design. The whole idea of this box is that you can print the container with the lid opened without any supports. After removing it from the print bed, you can simply close and use it right away. I'm starting off with a sketch on the right plane, which will be the side view. I first sketch out the container part, then I add the lid part. In this case, the lid part should serve two functions in two different positions. It should be printed onto the bed on its front face, but it should also obviously close the container. So I sketch the lid twice, once in the printing position and once in the closed position. Then I make sure that all the lengths are the same in both positions. I could implement this using dimensions, but using the equal constraint at this point is more flexible. As you can see, I can still drag points while the sketch is kept consistent. I add a circle where the hinge will be. The hinge, of course, must be consistent for both positions of the lid too. First, I add the tangency constraint between the hinge and the back lines of both positions of the lid. I also have to ensure that the vertical position of the hinge is consistent. I could use a construction line and an equal constraint here, but I've chosen to go with another technique. I add a driven dimension first for one position. Then I add a driving dimension for the other position. Here, instead of entering a value, I simply click the driven dimension I've just created and hit enter. As you can see, I still can drag my design and investigate how all these constraints, well, constrain my design. Now I add a few more basic dimensions. Then I think about the overhang angles and add a few more lines. I choose an overhang angle of 55 degrees. Don't worry, everything will become clear as soon as we extrude the parts. Also, we could always come back to the sketch and make changes, if it turned out that we had missed some detail. I will use symmetry in the end, therefore I'm going to design only half of the container first. I want to start with the main bodies of the container and the lid. For that, I extrude the relevant profiles before shelling the resulting bodies. I have decided to design the lid in the printing position. Then I add the hinge part of the lid. I select the relevant profiles and use the join option when extruding. Unlike the original design, I want to use a cone hinge here. If you are interested in different 3D printable hinge types, feel free to check out my other video on that topic, link in the description. I sketch a circle on the hinge face and extrude it using a taper angle of negative 35 degrees and a suitable extrusion distance. Then I extrude the hinge part of the container. Here I have to choose the new body option. For removing the cone, I simply cut the lid body from the new body, choosing the keep tools option. Now I can merge the hinge to the main body of the container. What is left to do is to add the clearances. I add a negative 0.3 mm offset on all faces that might slide against one another. On the cone face, I choose a slightly smaller offset of negative 0.2 mm. To correct for the reduced wall thickness, I also offset the relevant inner faces by positive 0.3 mm. I also might want to add a small negative offset to the lid's face touching the container to ensure that the box can be entirely closed. Finally, I mirror both bodies, choosing the join option before putting the bodies into separate components. While I'm doing that, feel free to hit like and subscribe in the meantime. The design is finished now and I check the clearances in a section view. To be able to visualize the motion of the lid, I want to add a joint. As the components are already designed in a consistent position, the quickest solution here is to use an as-built joint. I first ground the container via the context menu. Then I choose as-built joint. I select both components, set the motion type to revolute and select any of the circular edges of the hinge. Then I set the motion limits to just allow for closing the box. Now I can close and open the box by just dragging the lid using the cursor. In the section view, we can see that also in the closed position, everything looks fine. I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions, let me know in the comments. For ways to contact or support me, have a look at the description. Have a great time designing and prototyping.